I gotta love a mid-show cover. Before the break, I gave you the Hugo Think Sweaty Ken. Now I'm gonna face East and tell you they have a child called North, and yet his career's gone south. It is, of course, Kanye West. Still to come is a performance from musician James Hallett. We have our Fuzzy Friday Feels on its way, but now let's get chatting.
This is
Chit Chat. Our guest tonight is one of the most recognisable faces in Australian entertainment. A host, comedian, social commentator, author, and now artist with her eyes firmly set on trying to win an Archibald Prize. Please welcome Gretel Colleen!
That's a bit misleading. Thank you for having me, but my eyes are not firmly set on winning an Archibald Prize because I don't think I have the talent. I have a different kind of talent.
Really? I think you've got exactly the talent needed to win an Archibald Prize, because you actually entered the competition with a painting called She, which was an incredible painting with on social commentary on the awful messages women receive online. I think it's absolutely fantastic.
It's politically very, very profound and almost attractive.
Oh, that's a bit harsh. That's a bit harsh. Of course it's attractive. It's a picture and painting of you.
Do go on.
Now, 2019 sparked something special for you. It was the year you really got into painting after you went to a shop and you saw a painting that you loved but couldn't afford. So you went home and made your own. That's incredible.
Oh, it's a can-do attitude. but also it coincided with the bushfires in New South Wales. And so in Sydney, you know, that terrible thing where a whole lot of people all over Australia ended up with that app that could tell you if you could go out in the air, if it was a good idea. Yeah. I'm asthmatic, so it's not a good idea to have even less oxygen around. And so I started painting, one, because I was cheapskate and didn't want to buy another painting. I didn't rip it off. I just liked the colours. Just let that be said for legal reasons. But then I just kept painting, and then, of course, we had COVID, the 2020 COVID, and I'd just finished a draft of a novel that I was doing, and it was one of those weird things where I did not have something that I had to be doing, and so it was the perfect window to start painting, and then people started commissioning, which was just like magic.
Is painting then a way for you to get out all your thoughts and emotions and things that it would take too long for you to write otherwise?
They're not really alternatives, but I do think writing is a very labour-intensive form, certainly the way I do it. I'm finicky-dinicky with it, if anyone knows
finicky,
what I mean.
Finicky-dinicky?
Tweak, tweak, tweak. Whereas if I was saying it, it would be fine. It's bad for your posture, it makes you fat. What's the point? Blabbing on is much more fun. And painting, I guess, is the equivalent of blabbing on. But when you're doing commissions, you do want to please people, not just yourself. So it's like with stand-up or anything any of us do in the arts, it's some people think we just get up and do what we want, but actually you've got to connect with an audience. That's the big difference between being like a hobby or a career. You have to find that way to connect. So I can't just do a painting and hope that people will like it if it's commissioned. I mean, I do cross my fingers a lot and give them a wine when I hand the painting over. But it's about communicating. That's what we all have to do. It's not self-indulgent at all, unless you're being self-indulgent. And with any luck, it connects with someone else.
Well, speaking of connection, one of your artworks really connected with me. Love is Love. It's truly beautiful with an incredible message. And with that, you took a photograph that you'd taken, you had it enlarged, and then you painted over the top of it. Does working with a blank canvas free you up more than painting with over a photograph would, or does it fill you with a bit of stress and anxiety?
I really love working with photographs that I've taken, because then it's like a double layer art form. And that Love was a photo I took at a marriage equality rally. And I really do like combining the mediums. I think it's great because photography allows me to capture, and I can't really paint faces. Don't tell anyone.
No one will see this, I won't.
Yeah, people think, well, that's an interesting interpretation. It's not an interpretation, it's desperation. I can't paint it. So I make it look like it's snazzy, but it's really just complete lack of talent. So if I've got the photograph, which, and I can take a reasonable photo, you know, I've got a decent eye for those things. So that's enjoyable for me to join those layers together.
Oh, well, I think all of your artwork is incredible and it's certainly got really powerful messaging. And I do hope you re-enter the Archibald Prize because I think you should win it. Now, you haven't won the Archibald, but we do have the next best thing. Gretel Colleen, I want to present to you the inaugural Best Artist on Live from St Kilda for this episode award. This is for you.
I do go on and on and on. And thank you. And is it a quill? Is it an endangered species tusk? A unicorn's horn? What is it?
I think it's just what something prop made.
Or is it whatever you could find in the op shop?
Yeah.
I love it. Thank you.
Oh, our pleasure. We'll send that to you soon. Ah, now that sound, Gretel, means it's time to play This or That. We have had the opportunity to play it before, but we're going to play it again. 60 seconds on the clock, multiple choice questions with two answers. You can only choose one or the other, hence This or That.
I don't know, I'm scared, but give it a go.
All right, here we go. Gretel, your time starts now. On The Masked Singer, you were an octopus. If you went again, would you be a rhino or a parrot?
Parrot.
Okay, cool. What brings you more joy, painting or performing?
Performing.
Spring or autumn?
Are they equal?
Okay, sweet or savoury?
Savoury.
Would you rather bungee jump or go on a roller coaster?
Roller coaster with seatbelt.
Well, of course. Is it better to be the most famous person in a room or the least?
The least.
A movie filled with laughter or filled with tears? Aww.
Both. laughter.
And finally, should everyone jump online and order one of your excellent novels or commission a painting now?
You should commission a painting because they're worth more.
Of course. And sadly, that is all the time we have left. To find out more about Gretel's books and her really beautiful and often powerful artwork, please go to gretelcolleen.com.au or follow her on the socials at Gretel Colleen. Gretel, thank
you.
See
you later.
Oh, well, that tea has gone right through me, so sadly, I've got a dash. While you're waiting, it's time for a You Go Think. This celebrity puzzle is Shut It Now, Honey. That again is Shut It Now, Honey. We'll be back with more from live from St Kilda shortly. Where's the toilet?